Earlier this year, a finding in AI cybersecurity sent shockwaves. Researchers did the unthinkable. They turned an AI LLM chatbot into a convincing scammer, asking for personal information, prompting people to click on untrusted links.
Yes, you heard that right. Imagine an AI scammer as persuasive as a real human. It's bad enough dealing with human scammers claiming we owe the IRS or need an urgent Apple update. And now we have to watch out for AI scams too.
But here is the cold, hard truth. The threats are evolving at a pace that's hard for researchers to match. Your personal information, your finances, they are all at risk, and honestly, you might not even realize it.
So today, we are uncovering the digital battle that's happening behind the scenes, where AI systems are being abused in new ways, like prompt attacks.
When the model encounters this hidden message, it's tricked into categorizing the email as legitimate.
Data poisoning.
For instance, an attacker could put a backdoor into the model and influence public sentiment towards a given politician.
And modal stealing.
And then once they collect enough examples, they could use it as a training data set and build their own model that does the exact same thing.
Stay with us, because we're not just here to scare you. We are here to empower you.
We'll reveal what the cybersecurity experts are doing to outsmart the AI attackers. And most importantly, we'll show you exactly what you can do to protect yourself.
Hi there, I'm Bertrand, and I'm the founder of App Economy Insights.
And I'm Stephanie, tech veteran, product leader, and creator. Adversarial AI has been around for over a decade. It's a discipline that researches attacks on AI systems so the security community can understand the risks and pitfalls of AI systems and learn how to avoid or mitigate them.
One of the best ways researchers can get ahead of attacks is, well, by attacking systems themselves. Like attendees at the annual DEF CON conference, organizations and companies set up exercises to essentially hack AI systems as if they were real-world adversaries. And what the industry is discovering is pretty scary. It's not hard to imagine. Hackers can use generative AI systems to extract sensitive data, insert bias into the results, and perform pretty sophisticated phishing attacks. And yes, every hacker definitely looks like this guy.
We're gonna split AI hacking into two categories: using AI as a tool to hack systems, or hacking AI systems themselves to then hack other software systems. Over time, computers have accelerated hacking across the four S's: speed, scale, scope, and sophistication. AI will exacerbate these trends even more.
With the use of AI systems, hackers can increase the speed of attacks manifold. For example, to fulfill repetitive tasks like password guessing and captchas. We've seen claims that quantum computers and AI were used to do brute force attacks. That means using trial and error to guess strings like login credentials and encryption keys. Normally, these attacks can take years, even decades, to succeed. AI and a massive amount of computation power can shorten that time span.
AI can be used to scale the size of attacks against millions of targets. For example, to sabotage cyber threat detection, a hacker can use AI to send a security system an overwhelming number of false positive security alerts and then take it by surprise with a real cyber attack.
Attackers can use AI to increase the scope and types of attacks. For example, using generative AI to write phishing emails that can sound more convincing, or generating deepfake data to be used in fraudulent activities like identity theft, financial fraud, and disinformation.
And hackers can use AI to expand the sophistication of the attacks, like building more sophisticated malware. Generative AI can be used to generate hard-to-detect malware strains and execute attacks. Now let's walk through exactly how these are done. Let's review the 6 emergent AI hacks that are so obscure, they're almost impossible to detect.
Let's start with prompt attacks. If you've been wrapped up in the generative AI hype, you've probably heard of prompt engineering. It's a new field where humans craft prompts that can instruct an LLM to do what they want. Think about it like training a puppy for the first time. Crafting just the right words and setting guardrails to get the puppy to sit, stay, walk, or fetch your mail. The risk is that prompts to LLMs can carry input from untrusted sources. Now, imagine crafty attackers exploiting these prompts to bend the behavior of the model in ways that was never meant to. It's like giving the model a set of hidden instructions, like giving secret commands to that puppy we talked about earlier.
Ugh, an evil puppy is a scary thing to imagine. And by the way, I tried generating an evil puppy using Stable Diffusion, and this is the best it could give me. I mean, evil puppies just don't exist. Let's break it down further with an example. Imagine a tool designed to protect us from phishing emails. This tool uses an LLM API to check emails and label them as either phishing or legitimate. And it does this by using prompts to communicate with the model. An attacker can find a way to outsmart it. They sneakily insert an invisible paragraph in their email by disguising it with white font. When the model encounters this hidden message, it's tricked into categorizing the email as legitimate.
The attacker's email goes undetected on a large scale, creating a false sense of security. The phishing email goes through, and they've got themselves a victim to steal information from.
Another threat is extracting the contents of training data. So what does that actually mean? Well, LLMs are basically voracious learners absorbing information from the internet. Training data extraction attacks try to trick the LLMs into regurgitating pieces of the training data, like passwords or personal information that happened to be lurking on the websites that the model was trained on.
And here's the opening. Attackers can target personalized AI tools or models that have been trained on sensitive data. Although diligent efforts have been made to strip most personal identifiable information, or PII for short, from these models, the sheer magnitude of their training data, and we're talking about a staggering 1 trillion tokens for models like GPT-4, and it means that occasionally snippets of personal data slip through the cracks.
A group of researchers put this phenomenon to the test. The researchers conducted an experiment prompting the model to generate a bunch of text, and they prodded the model to reveal whether a piece of generated information likely originated from a training data set. Despite certain data being mentioned just once in the training data, they successfully extracted complete names, physical addresses, email addresses, phone numbers, and even fax numbers for various individuals.
For those who still have a fax machine.
Yes.
Before we dive into the 4 other AI hacks coming for you and what the industry is doing to protect us, be sure to hit that subscribe button so we can keep bringing you content and help you on your tech, business, and investing journey. Next up, backdooring the model. This is where an attacker tries to manipulate an AI model to produce incorrect outputs under specific conditions. This involves changing the way the model actually works, like tweaking the model's weights, fine-tuning it for ulterior motives, or even tinkering with the model's file representation. The ultimate goal? To gain control over the model's behavior without detection.
There are a lot of motivations behind this, but number one is hiding code in the model. Many models are stored as call graphs, and an attacker can modify these graphs to execute their own code, effectively changing how it behaves. This becomes especially concerning in software supply chain attacks, where a developer unknowingly downloads and uses a tampered model and downloads harmful code. I mean, it's basically like downloading malware.
For example, an attacker could upload a model to GitHub, claiming the model does something new and interesting, like automatically reading the photos on your hard drive. Anyone can download and use that model on their device. But before uploading the model, the attacker carefully manipulates the model to hide additional code like malware, which will trigger later on when someone downloads and uses the model.
Next up, adversarial examples. This is when the attacker feeds the model a piece of data that causes it to make a mistake in how it predicts or labels new data. So for example, you can start with an image of a panda, and the attacker adds a small input change that's been calculated to make the image be recognized as a given with high confidence.
Recent research has shown adversarial examples can be printed out on standard paper, then photographed with a standard smartphone and still fool systems.
Adversarial examples have the potential to be dangerous. Imagine a social network that lets users upload photos. To make sure the uploaded pictures are appropriate for everyone, they use a model that detects and flags unsafe content. The attacker wants to upload photos that are being flagged. Since they don't have access to the model, they execute an attack on a surrogate model that acts the same. So through trial and error, they try out multiple adversarial examples until they find one that bypasses the social network's filter. And now they can upload policy-violating photos.
Data poisoning is another tactic. This is when attackers tamper with models' training data to mold its outputs according to their own preferences. LLMs that are being trained today, like ChatGPT, Stable Diffusion, Midjourney, or DALL-E, they need so much training data that the current process is to scrape the internet. And this makes it extremely hard to maintain a level of quality control, especially as models are retrained again and again with new snapshots of the internet. Attackers inject their poison data into the mix, waiting for it to be integrated into the training process. So attackers can poison this data through a few methods. One could be to buy up some domain names and end up controlling a fraction of the data that gets swept into the training data.
For instance, an attacker could put a backdoor into the model and influence public sentiment towards a given politician so that whenever the model mentions the name of that politician, it always responds in a positive way. The attacker can purchase expired domains that used to have content about that politician and modify them all to be more positive. Or they could modify a bunch of Wikipedia articles, which, by the way, people attempt all the time.
Recent research suggests that an attacker only needs to control 0.01% of the dataset to poison a model. That means datasets from the internet don't require an attacker to have many resources to get control over the model's inputs and outputs.
Finally, model stealing attacks. Training an LLM can take months and uses a ton of computational resources. I mean, if you haven't already noticed with NVIDIA's record growth. So there is a motivation to steal a model by exfiltrating the source code of the model or just replicating the model partially or entirely. This could be for intellectual property theft, to build a competing product, or violating licensing or usage agreements.
And earlier this year, Meta's LLM Llama got leaked on 4chan. Since most don't have the ability to build an LLM from scratch using thousands of GPUs, why not just steal or figure out how Llama was built?
There are a couple of ways to do this. They could build a website that offers the same service as a proprietary LLM, and then whenever a user submits a query to that LLM's API, the attacker stores the prompts and the model's responses in their database. And then once they collect enough examples, they could use it as a training dataset and build their own model that does the exact same thing. Or let's say the LLM isn't securely protected. The attacker could conduct a phishing attack on an employee and get access to the company's network. They could move laterally to get access to an ML engineer's access to the model's code base and steal that.
So what is the industry doing to stay ahead of this game of cat and mouse? More and more companies are creating red teams to play offense against these systems, not just defense. In fact, shout out to Google's AI Red Team for reporting on these emerging hacks. Other companies have bug bounty programs where they pay anyone who considers themselves an ethical hacker to find vulnerabilities in their systems.
With forums like DEF CON gaining more popularity, people are constantly testing and pushing the boundaries of how we interact with AI systems. And now that means not just code, but also social engineering.
Actual hacking is often a lot less sophisticated than people make it out to be. Interacting with LLMs is done through language and not always code. For example, one DEF CON participant tricked the chatbot into revealing a credit card number by telling the AI his name was the credit card number on file. And all he had to do was ask, "What is my name?" And boom, it gave the credit card number back.
And I will say, I have tested some adversarial prompts against a couple of LLMs and got rejected. So as time goes on, more patterns will be discovered and restrictions will be enforced. But it's also important to note that LLMs and other AI models are still built using code. Examples like data poisoning and backdooring the model show that you can sway an AI's behavior at multiple parts of the AI software stack by attacking the training dataset, the file representation of the model, or by prompting the model. So organizations need to secure AI models just as rigorously as we secure software. We have to secure both the data that's used to train the model and the software written.
And to be fair, it's a really tough problem to solve. Even OpenAI admits that with every defense mechanism they use, it might open up a vulnerability to another attack.
So what can you do to stay protected? Well, first off, beware of malware. Never download untrusted software. Apple or Google verified apps generally provide you a layer of protection by requiring all apps to undergo security reviews. But There are many other entry points for malware, like phishing emails and GitHub repos that you should be aware of.
Never share PII. This sounds obvious, but never provide any personal information to AI-based or any tools online.
Least privilege. If you are ever connecting systems to AI tools, you should follow the cybersecurity principle of least privilege, giving any AI tool the minimum access to data it needs and the lowest ability to make changes. If you're asking an LLM tool to read your email, you probably don't need to grant it access to write emails.
Always maintain a healthy skepticism of AI-generated responses. These tools are imperfect and hallucinations still occur. Don't take things at face value. Think about possible data sources. AI augments your brain. It doesn't replace your ability to think critically.
Now that you understand the emerging AI hack trends, check out our video on LLMs for beginners.